set James free. The following day, James' head was cut off. So now Peter now is now up for execution. He is a number one apostle now. This is the guy who talks a lot, can't wait to cut his head off. But the saints are saying, but we're still going to pray. In spite of the fact that God did not answer our first prayer, we're going back to pray some more.
Oh, God.
There are some people who will give up on prayer when prayer is not answered. Sometimes God does not always say yes to your prayers. And just because God doesn't say yes doesn't mean you hang up praying. The Bible says the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. You cannot stop praying because you don't get your answer. So these new saints are in a hard place right now because we fast, we pray, we call on God to deliver James, and now James is dead. Now we're back in the same place, saying the same scripture, saying the same words, and asking God now to deliver our brother Peter. Oh my God, you got to have strong faith when things don't go right, when you've been praying and you're fasting and things just doesn't go your way. You got to be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord and not get up because you didn't get your prayer answered. Because sometimes God says no. And then sometimes God says wait a while. And then sometimes God says yes. So when do you stop praying? You don't stop praying. Jesus says men ought to always pray and faint not. You always believe that somehow God is able to hear you and he will have his way. So here we find that the saints know that Peter is up for execution. They know that he's locked in prison. They know he's in trouble. And we got to have a prayer meeting. We got to pray. We're dealing with demons and devils and spiritual wickedness in high places. We're dealing with a tough guy who doesn't play. And we got to pray. When we don't know what to do, I got to pray. Oh, God, I got to pray. I got to pray. I got to pray. When I don't know what else to do, I got to pray. So they called a prayer meeting. And that's where we find our text here in verse number 13. And they're praying that God would deliver Peter from prison. And that night, an angel showed up. And when the angel showed up, Peter was fast asleep. And I'm going to tell you one reason why he was asleep, because people were praying for Peter. When people pray for you, you can get more sleep. Though you are scheduled to die on tomorrow, but I'm sleeping tonight. When God gives you peace, who can make trouble? The Bible says. And so we find here this apostle Peter is fast asleep. The angel comes into the prison. The prison guards are asleep. He touches Peter, say, get up, we got to go. Let's get out of here. You got work to do. And so now Peter goes back to the house where they are praying for him. It is his small group ministry. He got some people who he's connected with. You're going to hear more about this small group ministry. I got some people who know where I am. And everybody ought to be connected to a small group one way or the other. So you can tell your group what's going on in your life. And so Peter is released from prison. And he's delivered in a miraculous way. And we find here in verse number 13, he goes to the house, Mary's house, John Mark's house, or Mary's house. And the Bible says in verse number 13, and as Peter knocked on the door, there was a prayer meeting going on inside of the house. Now, I don't know exactly what's going on, exactly what they were saying, but they were in the house saying something like, God, deliver Peter from Herod. Lord God, I know you can do everything, and there's nothing too hard for you to do. I don't know how many people were in the room, but there were enough people in the room that we could call it a prayer meeting. The saints were there. And there was a damsel, and she hearkened. Her name was Rhoda. There was a little girl who was also in this prayer meeting. This is what we're going to talk about, the spirit of Rhoda. There was a young little girl in this meeting, in this prayer meeting, and she was praying the same prayer that others were praying in that meeting. The name Rhoda, we will never hear this young lady's name mentioned again. This is the first time her name appears. It will never, ever appear in Scripture again. Again, we find it here in the book of Acts, chapter number 12, a young lady named Rhoda. She's the only one that we know who was in the prayer meeting by name. She was in the prayer meeting, and I want to talk about her life and her spirit, because there's something about Rhoda that we can learn from today. In verse number 12, we note that Peter, therefore, was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing. So Rhoda was in prayer. The first point I want to stress to you is that she was a praying young lady. In the midst of stress, she had prayer. In the midst of failure, she was still praying. And despite the fact that James had been killed, I'm still connected to prayer. So the spirit of Rhoda is that she's a girl who knows how to pray when things go wrong. She knows how to pray when she doesn't get an answer the way she thinks she ought to get an answer, but she's not giving up on prayer. Oh, God. So we know that she is a woman or a young girl of prayer. Now, this damsel is a person who is a servant. She was a servant girl. She's just simply in the house, just working in the house, working for the person who owns the house or happens to be there. But she's a damsel. She's a very young lady. And this damsel is a young servant girl, but she is in a prayer meeting. Verse number 6, we note that the meeting was at night. Look at verse number 6. And when Herod would have brought him forth, the same night, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers. We note that Rhoda is a young girl who's praying at night. It doesn't matter what time it is, I've got to pray. And when you have a burden that is so heavy on you, it doesn't matter what time it is, you've got to find the Lord and seek his face. If you need an answer from the Lord, it could be 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock in the morning, but I've got to seek the face of God. The spirit of Rhoda, it doesn't matter what time it is, I got to pray. Doesn't matter how many times God hasn't answered me, I'm going to still stick with prayer. So we notice two things quite early in the scripture. She's a little young girl of prayer. She's a young girl who's up late at night and she's praying. Notice here, as Rhoda is in this room, there was a knock on the door. The Bible says in verse number 13, and Peter knocked on the door of the gate. It's amazing that you have all these people in the room, but only one person hears the knock. Oh, God. Perhaps Rhoda sat close by the door, but she was close enough to the door that she heard the knocking of the door. I believe that when we get so close to God, we can hear the knocking of the door. We can sense how close God is. When we really get to know the voice of God and know the presence of the Lord, I can sense that God is here. This young girl is recognizing I'm hearing a knock. Maybe there are 120 people. Maybe there's 35 people in the room. But there's one young girl who says, I hear a knock. Oh, God. I want to go to a prayer meeting where I can hear a knock. I'm not hearing what everybody else is hearing. And maybe where baby Leroy is in the back and he's shouting and praising and speaking in tongues and running around. But I want to hear the knock. Maybe somebody is singing a song in the back of the church. But I want to hear the knock. So she hears a knock. The spirit of Rhoda is that she hears something that others are not hearing. Jeremiah 33:3, the Bible says, call on me, and I will show you great and mighty things that thou knowest not. I will show you a knock. And I believe with all my heart, we can be on our knees, and God can put a knock in our spirit. We can feel that there's something about the shift. I'm feeling a call of God. The third point we notice about Rhoda is that this young girl, she hearkens. That is, not only did she hear the knock, verse 13 says she got up. The door was locked, but she got up. Verse 13 says, and as Peter knocked on the door, she hearkened, or she got up. Her name was Rhoda. It's not a matter of just hearing a knock. It's a matter of responding to the knock. When God speaks to you, you get up and you do something. If God says forgive, you forgive. If God says let it go, let it go. He's knocking on your heart. If he says release it, you release it. So Rhoda, she gets up. The spirit of Rhoda is that she responds to the knock. And God is knocking on our hearts and telling us to do this and do that. And we got to get up because faith is dead without works. She goes to the door after hearing the knock. And verse 13 tells us, she goes, well, who's there? And Peter, who's knocking the door, she hears the voice of Peter, and she wants to know who's there. And I believe in prayer we have to ask God, who's there? In our prayer, the spirit of Rhoda is looking for an answer. I want to know who you are. We find here verse number 14. And when she knew that it was Peter's voice, look, Rhoda recognized, she recognized the voice of Peter. First she heard the knock, and now she recognizes the voice. The spirit of Rhoda is that you recognize the voice of God when God speaks to you. His sheep, they know the master's voice. And when we go before the Lord, there's got to be an ear that I can recognize the voice of God. For the most of you, if I called you by phone, you would recognize my voice because you always hear my voice. And so here we find Rhoda, she recognizes the voice of Peter. The spirit of Rhoda, she recognizes the voice. And we got to recognize the voice. Psalms 27, the scripture says, and when thou said, seek ye my face, my heart said, thy face will I seek. It's important we know that we know when God is speaking, because the God that we speak, he's a speaking, talking God. And the devil is speaking and demons are speaking, but it's so nice to know, I know the voice of God. And I know the voice of God because I have read his love letters, and when I read his love letters, I can tell how he speaks. I know his vernacular, I know his vocabulary, I know how he speaks. When I spend time with him, I recognize his voice. It's Psalms 91 that tells us, he that dwelleth in the secret of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. When you spend time and not long enough time with God, you begin to recognize the voice of God. It is the spirit of Rhoda. The spirit of Rhoda recognizes the sound of the voice. She recognizes his voice. Notice here also, as she recognizes the sound of the voice, she says, this is the voice of Peter. And so when she hears the voice, she runs to those who are in prayer. She doesn't open up the door yet. She's a young girl. I don't know who's out there with Peter. But she runs to those in the prayer meeting, and she says, with such joy, Peter is at the door. What you all are praying for, Peter is at the door. Rhoda says, stop praying. Peter is at the door. The thing that we're praying for is already at the door. How many times are we praying for things and it's already at the door? How many times are we waiting for God to do some things and he's already answered the prayer? Oh God. Oh, this prayer meeting may have been a dry prayer meeting. It may have been a quiet prayer meeting. But on the other side of the town, the prayer meeting was getting great results. In the prayer meeting, there were no goosebumps. There was no perhaps no running around, but on the other side of town, chains were being broken. On the other side of the town, doors were being up. Oh, don't play prayer cheap. And just because you're not running around the church and got goose pimples all over your skin, there's a God who hears and he knows, and he's opened up doors and he's making ways that no ways. Don't stop praying for your son. Don't stop praying for your daughter. Don't stop praying for your mother or your father or your brother or your sister. Don't you stop praying, because prayer works. And while in this prayer meeting, they didn't know what was going on the other side of town, but we're not going to stop praying until they begin to knock on the door. And when Peter knocked on the door, the little young girl ran, and Rhoda said, he's at the door. Sometimes we can be so stuck in prayer, we're not even looking for an answer. We're so caught up in prayer and so caught up in worship, we don't really expect God to open up a door. We're praying because the pastor said pray. We're praying because grandma prayed. But are we praying because of an expectation that he's going to be set free? Are we really praying believing that God can do anything but fail? Oh, but the spirit of Rhoda, I don't know why she left the folk, but it's time for me to stop praying. It's time for me now to open up a door. The devil doesn't care if you pray all night, but he's concerned if you open up the door. He's not concerned about your denomination or your background, but he doesn't want you to open up the door. You can look churchy, you can look religious, and have all the religious outward appearances, but the devil's not concerned about that. But don't you open up the door. Somebody's got to open up the door. And so this young Rhoda, she steps out of character. I know y'all praying, but it's time to stop praying and open up the door. I know you're talking in tongues, but it's time for you to stop talking in tongues and open up the door. I know it's not protocol for a servant girl like me to break up a prayer meeting, but I come to break up the prayer meeting and say, open up the door. Woo. worshiping. They called on God, but Rhoda said, but I got a word from the Lord. He's already at the door. The spirit of Rhoda, she steps out of the norm. All the folk in the room, and she steps out. Come on, y'all. He's at the door. You know, and how they responded? They say, you know what? They start calling her names. The church people in prayer. Oh, look at the verse. Some of y'all think I'm making this up. They start calling her names. But I thought y'all, you know, God is so faithful. And even though we're not perfect, he's still here. Our prayer. And though we have our own little issues, God said, I'm still going to bless you. The Bible says, it's of the Lord's mercies we not consume, because his compassion fails not. It's not because our prayers are so powerful. It's because God is so powerful. That's why he's answering our prayer. Not because we're so good, or so goody-two-shoey. No, it's because of his mercy and his kindness and his grace. He said to her, she said, hey, he's at the door. Hey, what we praying for, the answer's already here. Check it out, verse 13. You crazy. You're mad. It's here. It's verse number 15. They said unto her, you're crazy. You're off. You're mad. You're stupid. There's something wrong with you. He hasn't answered us yet. Something's wrong with your mind. Oh, God. Whew. Okay, fine. Well, I'm going home. I'm out of here. No, she didn't do that. Even though being called mad and insane and something wrong with you, notice her spirit. The Bible says she constantly affirmed he's at the door. Oh, God. I know you may put me down, but there's a miracle at the door. I know you think I'm crazy, but he's a healer anyway. I know you think there's something off, but he's a God over cancer cells. He's a God over the protons and neutrons. He can handle all of the chemicals in your bodies. There's nothing. Oh, you're mad. You're crazy. But she kept saying, yeah, but he's at the door. He's at the door. Somebody may call you crazy, but you gotta continue to confirm, but I got a word from the Lord. He's at the door. Girl, he ain't gonna bless you with no house. Your credit is too bad. Oh yeah, but I got my keys right here. He's at the door. The spirit of Rhoda, I'm not going to be moved by what you all say about me. I heard Peter's voice. I know Peter's voice. I know he's on the other side of the door. And that's why she continued to confirm and affirm he's at the door. When you know God's voice, you don't have to vacillate and you're in and out and I don't know what God said. But when you know God has said something and you know his voice, they can call you mad. They can call you stupid. They can call you crazy, but when you got a word from the Lord, you can talk about me if you want to, but I got a word from the Lord. He told me everything gonna be all right. He told me he's gonna make a way out of no way. Say, you crazy. We've been praying all night. He locked up. He in jail, girl. You silly. He's at the door. When you experience God, nobody can take away what you have experienced. That's why prayer is so important. We must be a praying church. We can be no greater than our prayer life. How is it you're so tight with God and you don't ever talk to him? That mean God, we like this. No, y'all not, because y'all don't talk. You all never talk. If you want to develop a relationship with the Lord, you got to talk to him. You got to speak to him. You got to bless him. You got to celebrate him. You got to lift him up. Because in the time of trouble, there's a conversation that's already pre-programmed in your spirit. So you don't want to get in trouble and then trying to learn how to pray when things are going wrong. You want to already be prayed up. This is what I do when the devil knocks on my door. This is what I say when I'm dealing with the enemy. It's something that's already in my spirit. And I'm ready to say that God is able. So she goes to the prayer meetings. Hey, he's at the door. No, you're crazy. Then they recognize somebody is outside. Check this out. They said, no, they're still not really ready to accept her report. And notice, too, that when she gets a word from the Lord, she's got to go tell somebody else. He's at the door. I heard a word. She becomes a witness. Now she becomes a preacher in the house. I'm coming here to tell you all that Peter is at the door. I got a word tonight. I heard a knocking on the door. Oh, yes, I did. And I don't know why you didn't hear it, but I heard a knock on the door. I went to the door, and I said, who's there? And I heard a voice. And that voice sound like Peter. I tell you, Peter, he's at the door. She became a minister in the house. She became a minister in the prayer meeting. And to begin to preach to the folk in the prayer meeting. And when you preach, folk gon' talk about you. Girl, you're mad. You're just mad. You're just something wrong with you. Just like your mama. All y'all crazy. All y'all chopped up. That's why you a servant girl. You don't know nothing. Go back where you were. She kept saying, no. No. Call me mad if you want to, but I got a testimony. Put me down if you want to, but I got a testimony. I heard Peter at the door. How can you be so quiet and you got the answer? Can you be so quiet and so when you know the thing that you're expecting? How can you go back in your prayer position? You got to change your position. Now I'm a preacher now. I'm Evangelist Rhoda, and I got to tell you that he's here. So she became a witness. And the folks still had problems. Look at verse number 15. And they said unto her, first, you're mad. You're crazy. You're off. But she constantly affirmed that it was even so. He is there. So then they said, no, it's an angel. It cannot be Peter. You see, they killed him, and the angel has come back to the house. It's amazing how we pray for things that we don't really believe that God is going to answer prayer. First, you're crazy. It's an angel, but he couldn't answer my prayer. Oftentimes we can believe that God will answer somebody else's prayer, but he won't answer my prayer. But the Bible says he's no respecter of person. He'll hear you just like he heard Moses and Samuel and Isaiah and Jeremiah and Elijah. He'll hear you just like he heard them. He's a God of no respecter of person. Because you got the Holy Ghost, I know he will hear you. It's the spirit of Rhoda. I can deal with the rejection. I can deal with folk talking about me. I can deal breaking out from the group and going to the... I can. The spirit of Rhoda is not afraid to stand out. The Bible says God has not given us a spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. That's the spirit of Rhoda. And so they say, well, no, you got to be mad. Well, you're not mad. It's just an angel out at the door. It's an angel. And Peter is... It's Peter. No, it's an angel. It's Peter. No, it must be a ghost. Claim the thing that God has said. Say what you've been praying for. I've been praying for promotion. It's got to be promotion. I'm praying for my boy to be healed. He has been healed. Claim it and say it. And don't start making stuff up. Well, it got to be an angel because, you know, when people die, they send angels. They're just making stuff up. Is they making stuff up? And they recognize it wasn't an angel. The message was at the door. They called her mad. But finally they opened up the door. And they were astonished. They were astonished. Oh my God. God answers prayer. First, they were suspicious. There was unbelief surrounding this whole verse. There was doubt in their praying. They're doubting and not really believing. There was scorn so strong that Rhoda was accused of being mad. They were skeptical to explain this supernatural occurrence. They said it was an angel, and they were astonished. Ah, but God was working in the midst. God was opening up doors in the midst. And so I come to encourage you to this morning, pray with believing. The Rhoda Spirit, she prays believing.